Good afternoon, everybody. I hope you're having a great day. Today, I want to talk to you about your identity. I was thinking today, especially about young girls, girls that might be in the 13-year-old to maybe 18-year-old phase of their life. I think that this might apply to everybody, but I'm particularly thinking about young girls because I'm raising a couple of teenagers right now. When I was growing up, I heard very loud and clear around me that lots of people had opinions as to what my identity was. I wasn't raised knowing too much of God. I wasn't raised ever going to any church or hearing the Bible stories or anything like that, or hearing music about God or anything. So I heard a lot of people's estimation of who they thought I was. And maybe they weren't particularly talking to me, but people would say, this is what girls are or do, or this is what women's worth is all about, or this is what Americans are like, or whatever, definitions of people that seem to be like me. And so I would think, oh, okay, well, this is what women are supposed to be, or this is what girls are supposed to be. And yet their identities and their definitions of my identity, they changed. It wasn't like two people agreed. And then people that would speak about me particularly didn't agree. So there were the people that liked me and even people that loved me in my own family. But then there were some people that didn't like me or didn't relate to me. So it's pretty confusing growing up and just trying to figure all of that out. And I think that girls today probably have it even harder because there are so many messages on the internet and television and movies and music and among friends of who girls are supposed to be or who women are supposed to be and who people are supposed to be. It's confusing. You're living with a lot of opinions in the world. So when I was 15, that's where I first learned what God thinks of me. And God says, I'm worthy and you're worthy. God called me beloved and calls you beloved. You know, girls and women think about the idea of being beautiful. And what does that even mean? And girls look at magazines and compare themselves to people that are models and think, well, that's a standard of beauty that I don't relate to or that I don't embody. And God said that I was beautiful at 15. And I realized that God's opinion wasn't just one opinion among many, but God's opinion was the truth of who I was. And either people could see that truth and align with that truth or not. And either way would be fine because the truth would stand. And I realized that I was a lot happier and healthier and more peaceful and more confident when I aligned with that truth than those times when I didn't. So for me, what that took was spending time reading a little bit of the Bible every day. When I was a teenager, I'd come home from school and before my homework even, I'd take out the Bible and I'd read a little bit. I liked reading the Psalms, which is around the middle of the Bible. So I'd read one Psalm every day. You know, I still do this. I'm not 15 anymore. I'm almost 49. I still do this every day. I read a Psalm every day. And then even as a teenager, I'd write in a journal about what I thought that God was telling me. And you know, what that did for me then was it gave me a kind of an armor, a sense of strength, because the world was still throwing messages at me as to who they thought I was. But I knew the truth. And I've gone through periods of my life where I've focused on that truth. And I've gone through periods of my life where I have forgotten that truth. And then I get tossed around by opinions. That's never easy, but the truth is always there and we can easily return to it. So it does help to pick up the Bible and to have a journal and to talk to God about who you are. Say the prayer, God, show me what's true. When you know your identity, it's like you're in a boat with a strong rudder and there could be waves all around you, but you're not tossed about. You know what's real. And you can stay strong and you can stay, it's not a fake sense of strength. In fact, you're strong enough to be vulnerable. You're strong enough to be authentic. You're strong enough to be real. You don't have to pretend to be strong, but you do have an inner core of strength when you know who you are in this world. So I want to encourage young girls out there, especially, to remember who God says you are. You're still going to hear all of those other opinions and your own inside your own head. But remember, there's one truth from the one truth giver, and the truth giver is the one who made you and made you to be beautiful exactly the way you are. So I hope that you can agree with that truth, align with that truth, and do what it takes daily to remind yourself of that truth. It can too easily be forgotten, but you're worth it. You deserve it. And if you keep that truth ever before your eyes, you'll be able to withstand any storm, any waves of people's opinions. You know which opinion counts. Have a wonderful day. Bye-bye.